mobile app, on your Alexa-powered smart speaker, and on TuneIn, iHeart, and on Odyssey. Now, from the Signature Bank Studios, this is Chicago's Morning Answer with Dan Proft and Amy Jacobson on AM 560, The Answer.
They're making me do this segment because right now, yesterday in Capitol Hill, it was the biggest UFO hearing ever. And a lot of questions were asked to a whistleblower. His name is David Grush, former U.S. Intel officer, and Jamie Raskin started it off.
Are there common characteristics to the UAPs that have been cited by different pilots? And can you describe what the convergence of descriptions is?
Certainly. We were primarily seeing dark gray or black cubes inside of a clear sphere.
I'm sorry, dark gray or black cubes?
Yes, inside of a clear sphere, where the apex or tips of the cube were touching the inside of that sphere. And that was primarily what was being reported when we were able to gain a visual tally of these objects. And that occurred over almost 8 years. And as far as I know, it's still occurring.
Matt Goetz getting involved.
And when he showed us the photo that he'd taken, I asked why the video wasn't engaged, why we didn't have a FLIR system that worked. Here's what he said. They were out on a test mission that day over the Gulf of Mexico, and when you're on a test mission, you're supposed to have clear airspace, not supposed to be anything that shows up. And they saw a sequence of four craft in a clear diamond formation for which there is a radar sequence that I and I alone have observed in the United States Congress. One of the pilots goes to check out that diamond formation and sees a large floating, what I can only describe as an orb, again, like I said, not of any human capability that I'm aware of. And when he approached, he said that his radar went down, he said that his FLIR system malfunctioned, and that he had to manually take this image from one of the lenses, and it was not automated in collection, as you would typically see in a test mission.
And then the greatest question asked, you know, what has our government made contact with intelligent extraterrestrials, otherwise known as aliens?
If you believe we have crashed craft, stated earlier, do we have the bodies of the pilots who piloted this craft?
As I've stated publicly already in my News Nation interview, biologics came with some of these recoveries. Yeah.
Were they, I guess, human or non-human biologics?
Non-human, and that was the assessment of people with direct knowledge on the program I talked to that are currently still on the program.
Okay, see, the reason why I've been avoiding this UFO story, and when Trump was in office, he talked about it, and we started the Space Force for a reason, right?
Yeah.
I can't put this on my plate right now. There's so much to worry about in the world.
Still dealing with COVID.
That we're still dealing with, you know, effects of COVID. We're still, you know, fighting for our kids to have spaces and Chicago Park districts, that I can't possibly be worried about UFOs coming to get my animals or possibly me. So with more on this, we're bringing in an expert, Jazz Shaw, contributor to hotair.com and The Debrief. Good morning, Mr. Shaw. How are you? Are you there?
Hello.
Hello. Oh, aliens briefly took that over. No. So, hi, can you hear us?
I can hear you if you can hear me.
I can hear you now. So what did you learn from yesterday's congressional UFO hearing? Hello, Mr.
It's the aliens.
Do you think it's the aliens?
Yes, the non-humans.
So now you can't hear me again?
There he is.
No, we can hear you now.
I haven't touched a thing over here, folks. So I don't know what's going on your end. Maybe it is the aliens. No, as I was starting to say, I didn't learn too much because I follow this obsessively, and I've already heard everything all three of those witnesses have had to say. I've watched and read their interviews and all that stuff. But I think that a lot of the country, and this got massive media coverage, a lot of people were hearing this for the first time, and a lot of them are going to be really surprised at what those people said. But yeah, we knew most of this was going on. I've talked to two of the people that were there myself, Commander Fravor and Ryan Graves, and their experiences are, hate to use the phrase, out of this world. So,
well, what are they seeing? Just walk us through this. Are we talking about aliens that are dead that are in the Pentagon, or what is this?
No, nobody's seen the aliens yet that's come forward directly. The main witness, Dave Grush, has admitted he's never seen an alien spaceship, non-human intelligence, he says. We're not supposed to say extraterrestrial.
Okay.
Spaceship. He hasn't seen the bodies. He hasn't touched it. But he has spoken to a bunch of people. We have the same vastly high levels of security clearances deep inside the system, who said they have been working for years, and in some cases decades, on programs where they have been recovering UFOs, sometimes intact, sometimes part, and then in some cases they have recovered what they call biologicals, dead pilots, and they're not human.
Wow. And where are they taking these biologicals?
Where? Mm-hmm. He stated during the hearing that he has provided that information in closed sessions, but when he went through the DOPSER processes where you get permission to talk about sensitive things in public, he wasn't approved to release that publicly, but he has told the members of Congress in classified settings in SCIFs the names of the companies. It's almost certainly one of them is Lockheed Martin. Lockheed Martin's been in this since the beginning. So it's probably Skunk Works, yeah.
Wow. So why did President Trump create a space force? What does he know that we don't? Or the information that he was given that we were not?
I think that this may be, maybe, and not confirmed, part of it. But I do think people are focusing on that a little bit too much, because the space force really was created in recognition of the fact that we have been massively falling behind China and to a certain extent Russia in terms of the weaponization of satellite systems in low Earth orbit. The Chinese have very aggressive attack satellites that are maneuverable and can take our satellites out. And back when Obama was in charge, there was a push for us to get on the same thing, but Obama didn't want to do it, and we dropped the ball. And now we're pretty far behind, and the Space Force is supposed to be addressing that shortcoming.
Wow. You know, as I think about the vastness of the universe, anything is possible. But so does that mean that Area 51, is that real? When you think about the leap in technology, we went from, as I think Quinn said, from the outhouse to the iPhone in what, 10 years? Or could this be a distraction? What is this a distraction from? Could this be other governments, or could this be our very own government to distract us from something?
I hear that going around a lot, too. I no longer have the luxury of not believing in UFOs. My wife and I have seen five of them, which is one reason I cover it so obsessively, and I'm always looking into it. But it also, people have suggested maybe this is disinformation that David Grush was given because somebody wanted him to go tell this story, and they knew it would blow up all around the world. By the way, he has claimed during his interviews, and I don't think it did come up during the hearing, that's right. It's not just us, according to him. He has information that he has turned over that says we're actually in something of a space race with Russia and China, who also have similar programs and who have also collected downed UFOs.
Well, how many UFO sightings have there been, say, in the past year? And is it mostly our military that's seeing that, or just, you know, regular Americans?
Sightings?
Yeah.
Okay. Because the recovered craft, we're talking 10 to 15, according to him.
Okay.
That they currently have. Sightings, they're in the thousands. They're investigating more than 800 of them at the Aero office. That's the all domain anomalous. Oh God, now I'm dropping a digit. They changed names. They've changed names like five times. But they're tracking more than 800 that they haven't been able to figure out, and there are thousands more reports. Ryan Graves has started a civilian agency to work with civilian commercial pilots because they have no way to report them, and traditionally they get in trouble if they do, but they see them all the time. They see the same things. The most common ones, like you heard in that clip, are these bizarre orbs, and they show up in air lanes all around the world. And they're just these balls that sometimes they look metallic and sometimes they're clear and they have like a black or gray cube inside of them that touches the edge of the sphere. And they somehow fly and they maneuver and do things, but they have no wings, they have no engines, they got nothing.
But somehow they get out of the way of the commercial flights, right?
Oh, yeah. There haven't been any collisions that we know of, but Graves himself had to file a flight safety report because on one of his flights out with his team off the coast of Virginia, he had one that, and it was on radar and visible and came, as he put it, within 25 feet of his plane. He had to perform an evasive maneuver because he was afraid it was going to hit him.
Wow.
He's shocked, frankly, that nobody's hit one yet because they see so many of them, particularly off the coast of Virginia and Florida.
Well, what about that family in Las Vegas recently or outside of Las Vegas? They said that they had two aliens in the backyard. They called the cops. The police officers came. Do you know what came of that?
Yeah, I've heard it's been partially debunked. I watched the films and stuff. There was a meteor that night that lots of people saw. And some people interpreted maybe it wasn't a meteor, maybe it was a ship landing. And this one family said they looked out in their backyard in front of the commercial garage they run, and there was some sort of craft there, and there were three beings that were 8 to 10 feet tall. But nobody got them on film or anything. So and this isn't something that Arrow's looking at. This is one of those things that just shows up, you know, on Ancient Aliens.
Hey, what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. You know what I mean?
Right.
What about the lizard lady, the lady that's on the plane, basically saying that this man was remember she said, look, this guy back there, she was on the plane with him, sitting next to him in a hoodie, saying that he had basic lizard eyes or looked like a lizard. And it took me to the show Secret Invasion with Samuel Jackson. You follow Hollywood. Hollywood has a way of ingraining things into the everyday culture and make it acceptable. So what's with that? Do you believe in lizard people? Do you think they come in that form, or are they the big head, short people, the long, skinny arms, long, skinny fingers? I mean, you think about it. We have all this technology, and we haven't been able to capture them on film or picture.
Well, just to be clear, I've never seen a creature. Yeah. I've only seen the ships or whatever they are, and I only have the lore and stuff to go on, and now the stuff that's getting put into the congressional reports. The one thing everybody seems to agree is that they're not all coming from one place. Excuse me. Because the vehicles are just, there's so many different types of them. There literally are saucers that are still seen. There's the Tic Tac ones, which is what David Fravor chased that he was talking about off the coast of California. They look like giant propane tanks, basically. And then there's those orbs that show up everywhere. And so they're probably coming from different places. And, yeah, you hear reports. The most common ones are what are referred to as the little grays.
Yeah.
And grays. They have the big heads and the slit mouths and the big oval black eyes. But, yeah, people do talk about reptilians. There's also insectoids, things that look like really tall praying mantises that get reported. And then there are what are classically called the they basically just look like humans, and except they're always stunningly beautiful for some reason. I don't know how that works.
Yes.
And but they're not from here. They used to refer to them as Venusians, but I'm pretty sure we've ruled out they actually come from Venus, which is a hellhole.
Why
but,
now?
Yeah.
Why
so
now?
There's different types.
Right. Wait.
Just on the day that Hunter Biden's plea deal goes awry.
Timing's
everything.
Yeah, that's my point.
Congressional
that's my point.
Hearing. All right, Jay Shaw, we're going to have to leave it there for today. I do want to share with you a great text message we got on our text line, our turnkey.pro text line. John and Amy, Democrats will believe a UFO whistleblower, but not an IRS or FBI whistleblower.
That's great. That's
so
amazing.
All right, Jay Shaw, you can read his work at hotair.com. Did you want to say something else?
No, I just wanted to wish well to everybody in Chicago, and I find myself wondering how you guys are surviving under that new mayor of yours. Holy cow, the headlines coming out are just depressing.
Oh,
I live in Joliet.
We're just getting started. So,
yeah.
All right, thank you, Mr. Shaw, contributor to hotair.com and The Debrief, and he joined us on our turnkey.pro answer line.
It's what Chicago is talking about. It's Chicago's Morning Answer with Dan and Amy on AM 560, The Answer.
You can't live forever, but your legacy can. For over 185 years, families have trusted Catholic Cemeteries of Chicago, with 47 locations throughout Cook and Lake counties, to set their legacies in stone. A prepaid cemetery plan locks in today's prices and safeguards against rising inflation. Visit CatholicCemeteryChicago.org or call 708-236-5490 to schedule a free consultation today.
Rick Borick, host of Unleash Your Wealth, talks about the importance of tax planning in retirement.
A qualified financial planner can take you through all the steps to show you every single legal way you can use to reduce and minimize your state income taxes across the board so that, again, you keep more of your money and your family keeps more of your money.
Unleash Your Wealth, Saturday at 7 a.m. and our new time at 2 p.m. here on AM 560, The Answer.
All right. I keep thinking, Elliot.